If you want to be spoiled, come on in.
Do not watch unless you have watched the full season of I Am Not Okay With This.
Hi, I'm Wyatt Olaf.
And I am Sophia Lillis.
My name is Richard Ellis.
And my name is Sophia.
We're going to be taking you through that scene.
Shot by shot.
Do you want to dance?
This is homecoming. This is really exciting because I really wanted to show off my dance moves.
Oh, so cute.
So sweet.
All of our dancing was just like all on the spot, but this was pretty simple. It was just like, oh, waltz. And I was like, I think I know what that is.
The room, well, it was packed.
Basically, it was this abandoned school in Pittsburgh, yeah. And the whole top floor was just this gymnasium, and they just turned it into a homecoming
party. Yeah, it
was party.
Really cool.
That's also the same gym that we shot in episode 105.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, if I may have your attention, stop talking, look up here, please.
Oh, he was
so
funny.
Mr. File.
Mr. File was improvising all of his lines on that part, and it was just a different take every time. It was hilarious.
So hilarious.
Your homecoming king and queen, Jeff Butters and Julie Frischeschi.
So at this point, it's nice.
It's like, oh my gosh, finally.
Finally something went right.
Yeah.
Until.
I want to thank my mom for meeting my...
And here I am.
There's Richard.
Richard.
Love that man.
Give me a second.
Brad is unraveling at this point. He just got caught being a terrible person, and he was drinking a little bit before this, and he
a lot of it.
I would like to take this moment to talk about something very important that affects everyone here. Sydney Novak. Hey, Sydney.
I just remember doing this, and the two Sophias were standing there, so it was really directed right at them.
It was really hard to watch this without laughing, though.
What a lot of people don't know about Sydney here, she's one hell of a writer.
Wait.
Journal.
Journal.
The diary.
Look.
What was cool about it is it was a fully formed diary, so it felt really authentic. And I went through everything, every intimate secret that she had.
It I actually wrote in the beginning to kind of get into the character and stuff, but it was the beginning. So when I looked back on it, I was like, what did I just write? What is this?
You know, it's funny, because everyone is so fast to call me an asshole.
Everything was really falling down on Syd in this specific moment, but it was also kind of falling on me in a different way, where it's like, I'm learning tons of new information, or well, almost do. So Dina has like 80 million questions.
Both of you were so in it too.
I was downstairs, Ben and Jenny Tuffield at Ricky's. Guess what Sydney was doing upstairs? She was kissing my girlfriend. Now don't get me wrong, chicks get drunk, they make out sometimes.
This scene where he's coming close to me.
It's like all night?
It was all night, yeah. Good section of it, anyway.
I'm all for it, but being a full-on dyke, that's a whole other ballgame.
Like that, this is a big scene. I'm really upset. Also, I'm upset because Wyatt in the background.
I was in like the background of one of the takes on accident, like pushing a balloon.
So I was really upset when watching Richard, who was great, and I see you whacking a balloon. And that was so hard.
Don't even get me started with the daddy issues on this one. Everyone in her life thinks that she's a piece of shit. And I mean, everyone.
Hey man, leave her alone!
I was so excited for that beat.
Oh, you don't know how excited Rich was when he got to do that.
We were looking forward to that for weeks, because as we became friendlier, Wyatt would always say, oh, you get to punch me in the face later.
Rich has a lot of experience, like fighting, I don't know. And he like knows, he knows how to properly throw a punch.
Yeah.
We had to block out the whole thing in another room, and we had a stunt coordinator kind of going over how to make it look like a movie punch.
His fist was maybe all the way over here. We were very far away from each other, and I had to practice, because like when you get punched, it's like one body and then legs follow. That was fun.
God. And he went flying onto pad. We did it a lot. I had to fake punch Wyatt a good deal.
Hey man, leave her alone!
But that is not even the weirdest thing about Sydney.
Real tear.
Good actor.
Thanks.
Shut up.
No, Ben.
It's like everything's building up here to come to an emotional conclusion, but I don't know what it is.
I don't know, what is it?
I feel like pressure on my head.
Oh no.
Shut up.
Get this, Sydney, clean.
Shut up.
She has.
Oh my God, oh my God.
It's still so funny.
Look at everyone just like.
The poor extras had no idea how covered they were about to get.
They just thought they were gonna stand around and watch some sort of special effects thing happen. So the first take was actually like real reactions. Those people did a really good job.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Pittsburgh residents.
Thank you, Pittsburgh residents.
So we had this giant like blood balloon essentially that they just stuck in the middle at the same height that my head was at.
And it would just like expand and like no one really knew when it was gonna blow. So it was really like a surprise.
And they had this dummy that was wearing the same exact outfit that I'm wearing.
Just like
oh,
you.
It was really weird.
It was so creepy.
And I just sat on the bleachers and watched everybody get drenched.
I was like showering for like six
days
and it was like pink. Beforehand, we doused ourselves. Like, you know what you do with hot wings? Like, that was like us.
A few hours of just the makeup people just splatting on them blood. I was so sweaty. It was went on for so long.
Up in your arms, too late to beg you. Okay.
Oh yeah, the blue suit. That is the most bestest suit ever.
That's a word.
It's, yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.
It's pretty fantastic, and that's why it shows up in the show twice, because it's the only formal thing in Stanley's closet. The suit was actually also handmade by the costume designer, and it is wonderful.
Up against a windhill, through the thick and
I shot this before the head explosion scene. It was the first shot I ever had with the blood outfit. Just did a lot of running in this.
Looks
yes.
great.
Thank you. It was cool. Got a good exercise. The camera was, I think, was on like a little platform thing, and someone was driving it, and I was just running. It was pretty slow, though. I had to slow down a lot.
Thanks for coming with us through
that scene, shot by shot.
I tried to be normal.